Dear friends, I am Dr. K. M. Kathiresan, Director, Center for Graph Theory, Ayya, Nadar, Janaki, Ammal College, Sivakasi. Today, let us discuss something about Descartes' rule of science. The fundamental theorem of algebra states that every polynomial of degree n having complex coefficients has at least one root in the complex field, and hence that polynomial has all the n roots in the complex field. Now the question is, without finding the roots, can we able to find the number of positive roots, number of negative roots, and the number of imaginary roots of the equation? Of course, without finding the roots, we can't say anything about the exact number of positive roots, negative roots, and complex roots, but we can give an upper bound for the number of positive roots and the number of negative roots, and we can give a lower bound for the number of imaginary roots of a polynomial. That rule is known as Descartes' rule of science. Suppose p of x is a polynomial with the real coefficients. Then the number of positive real roots cannot exceed the number of changes of sign in p of x. So first we find the number of changes in sign in the coefficients of p of x. If we know that number, then the number of positive real roots is less than or equal to that number. And the number of negative roots cannot exceed the number of changes of sign in p of minus x. So in p of minus x, we find the number of changes. Suppose s is the number of such changes of sign, then the number of negative roots is less than or equal to s. This is the Descartes' rule. How to apply this rule for a problem? Suppose s is the number of sign changes in the coefficients. Let p be the number of positive real roots. Then the rule states that p is less than or equal to s. The number of positive real roots is always less than or equal to s. And there is a relationship between this number p and this number s. They are congruent to s modulo 2. P is congruent to s modulo 2. If s is equal to 1, then p equal to 1. Because if s is equal to 1, by the first fact we have p is less than or equal to 1. So either p equal to 0 or p equal to 1. And at the same time, this p must be congruent to s modulo 2. Here s is equal to 1, so p must be congruent to 1 modulo 2. So p is less than or equal to 1, and p is congruent to 1 modulo 2 means p is equal to 1 is the only possible way. So when s is equal to 1, the number of positive roots is exactly 1. Suppose s is equal to 5. Then the possible values for p are 5, 3, 1, because p is less than or equal to 5. And at the same time, it must be congruent to 5 modulo 2. So the possible values which are less than or equal to 5 and congruent to 5 modulo 2 are 5, 3, 1. Or in other words, If we know the value for S, then the values for P are S, S minus 2, S minus 4 and so on. S unudaya value therindhal, P unudaya value kandupidipadharku, S unudaya value lirundhu aramithu, 2 2 aga kuraithu varungal. If S is equal to 8, then the possible values for P are 8 minus 2, 6, 6 minus 2, 4, 4 minus 2, 2, 2 minus 2, 0. These are the possible values for P. If S equal to 1, then P is less than or equal to 1. And P is congruent to 1 modulo 2 means P is equal to 1 is the only possible case. So when S is equal to 1, P is equal to 1. Now what is the rule for the number of negative real roots? To find the number of negative real roots of the polynomial, we consider P of minus x and we use the similar technique as used in P of x. Let S be the number of sign changes in the coefficients of P of minus x. Suppose k is the number of negative real roots, then the Descartes rule states that k is less than or equal to S and k is congruent to S modulo 2. If S equal to 1, then k equal to 1, because k is less than or equal to 1 and k is congruent 1 modulo 2 implies k is equal to 1. For example, consider this polynomial 4x power 7 minus 3x power 5 plus 2x cube plus 2x square minus 1. Now write down the signs plus, then minus, then plus and minus. Here plus to minus, so there is a change. Minus to plus, another change. Plus to plus, there is no change. Plus to minus, another change. So there are three changes. So S is equal to 3. Therefore, the number of positive real roots is either 3 or 3 minus 2, that is 1. So the number of positive real roots is either 3 or 1. Now to count the number of negative roots, we consider this P of minus x. We replace x by minus x. Then we write down the signs of P of minus x. Minus, then plus, then once again plus, and then minus. Minus to plus, there is a change. Plus to plus, there is no change. Plus to plus, there is no change. And plus to minus, another change. So there are two changes in sign. Therefore, the number of negative roots is less than or equal to 2 and congruent to 2 modulo 2. That means the number of negative real roots is either 2 or 0. So for the equation, for the above equation, the number of positive real roots is either 3 or 1, and the number of negative real roots is either 2 or 0. And the degree of this polynomial is 7. Let T be the number of imaginary roots. Then what are the possible values for T? Take any number from the first column and take any number from the second column and take any number in the third column. Find the sum. The sum must be equal to 7. Because this polynomial has exactly 7 roots. So one possibility is 3 plus 2 plus t equal to 7. From this we get t is equal to 2. Another possibility is 3, 0, t. In this case we get t is equal to 4. Another possibility is 1 plus 2 plus t equal to 7. Here we get t is equal to 4. Another possibility is 1 plus 0 plus t, which is equal to 7. That implies t is equal to 6. So the number of imaginary roots is either 2 or 4 or 6. That means this polynomial has at least two imaginary roots. So 3, 2, 2 means number of positive real roots is 3, number of negative real roots is 2, and the number of imaginary roots is 2. This is one possibility. Similarly, there are 4 possibilities. I will consider another polynomial. Consider this polynomial. And this polynomial can be written in this form, x square into, etc. Now let us write down the signs of p of x, plus, minus, then plus and minus. Here there is a change from plus to minus, there is another change from minus to plus, another change from plus to minus. So there are 3 changes. So the number of positive real roots is either 3 or 1. And in p of minus x, we write down the signs of the coefficients. Minus to minus, no change. Minus to minus, no change. Minus to minus, no change. So there is no sign change in p of minus x. Therefore, the number of negative roots is less than or equal to 0. That means the number of negative roots is exactly 0. We write down all these in tabular column. The number of positive roots is either 3 or 1. The number of negative roots is 0. And here we observe that x is equal to 0. 0 is also a root of multiplicity p of x. Multiplicity 2 for p of x. So 0 is a root of multiplicity 2. Suppose t is the number of imaginary roots. Then the number of positive roots plus number of negative roots plus number of 0 roots plus number of imaginary roots has to be equal to 9. So take a number in the first column, take another number in the second column, take another number in the third column, and another number in the fourth column, the sum must be equal to 9. Using this fact, there are 2 possibilities, and the first possibility we get t is equal to 4, and in the second possibility we get t is equal to 6. So this p of x has at least 4 imaginary roots. So in this way, you can find the upper bounds for the number of positive roots and the upper bounds for number of negative real roots of a polynomial, and also the lower bound for the number of imaginary roots of a polynomial. Thank you.